Hi, welcome to Kitchen Wargames. My name is Mark, and welcome to my kitchen. This is where everything happens for me. I haven't got my own studio or setup area, so basically, every time I paint, play, or make any models, I keep everything outside in a little shed and have to bring it in here each time. Which is a bit inconvenient, but we've got a small house and my wife doesn't like me models in here. So, yeah. So, what we're about. Basically, we're a couple of wargamers. I've been playing way back since Warhammer Edition 1. And been playing ever since then. A few years back, though, I stopped wargaming. Well, say a few years ago, about 5, 6, 7 years ago, and I sold everything, got rid of everything. Anyway, I'm mad on World War II, and I came across bolt action, and I was immediately sold again and wanted to get gaming. So I got in touch with a family member who's Wayne, who you'll meet when we're playing games, and also my old time gaming pal, Tom. Again, you'll be meeting later. We got together and decided to play bolt action. So I had to start from scratch. I haven't got as much time as I used to have to paint and model and everything like that. So we probably play about one game a week or one game every other week. In the meantime, I'm trying to build everything up, as you can see. I've got a couple of armies. I've got Germans, got Allied, which is mostly American, but I'm building some British with paras and infantry. And I've got a Soviet army, which I'm just building up at the moment as well. Quite a formidable size. And even the point systems on the Russians, especially for the tanks, you can get quite a few tanks on the table. Our game size, we tend to play anywhere from 500, 1,000, 2,000 is the maximum we play. But when we do play the 2,000 games, what we do with that is to allow more vehicles, basically. So we start off, say, like 1,000 points, a bit more just on the vehicles, and then the rest is your troops. So you're not like washed out with troops. Just get more vehicles on the table. Painting wise, I used to paint models to what's probably called a very high standard. I used to paint all their eyes, do the shadings of the faces, washes, contrasts, spend time on the bases and everything like that. But I don't want to get away with things too much, but basically I had a bit of a medical problem. I had to have an operation on my head. Basically, that's why I've got the wonky eye, and due to that, I haven't got much depth perception. So when it comes to painting faces, especially trying to do eyes, I don't know how far I am from the model. So as I'm trying to go in, splodge, make a mess. So basically, I paint things to a standard that I think a lot of people might do, or some people might be afraid of painting models. So I've seen a lot of people playing models unpainted, and there's millions of hundreds of sites on YouTube, fantastic painters. I watch them all, and they've got superbly painted models. So I'm thinking more lines to me where you can't put that, or you're not to that stage where you can put all the details in on models, and you can feel a bit lost about painting. Like you think you've got to be as good as the people you see on YouTube or you see in the books. But as we go along with this channel, I'll show you how I paint things, and hopefully it'll show you that you can get paint jobs quickly done, easily done, that have an effect that's good enough for the gaming table, and they look neat and everything and ready to go. Also, we're going to cover modelling. So I'll show you how I put things together, and especially messing about with niggly bits on vehicles and everything like that. Sometimes I break the little pieces, or I just can't fit them in, so I'll miss them off. And I'll hopefully show you guys that missing things off models isn't the be all and end all. You can get away with it, especially when it's on the table and you're actually playing a game. People don't like, pick up your model and say, "Oh, there's a little runner missing there," or "Oh yeah, I'll put the antenna on there," or something like that. It's what's on the table, looks good, looks nice, and the main thing why we're here is to play the game. Also, I'm going to talk about how we put a table together, because obviously I haven't got a table as such, not a dedicated gaming table. So this is my kitchen table. This mat here that's on it is from Deep Cut Studios. It's one of their mouse mat ones, which is very flexible, and as you can see, it drapes around this round table quite nicely. It's a 6 foot by 4 foot, so when I do get a bigger table, which I'll show you when we're setting up, that's outside as well. But it's not a table as such, it's pieces of styrofoam that builders use, and I lie them together on top of this table, and then the mat goes over and basically makes me a 4x4 table that's easily packed up, put away around the side of the house. So I'll show you all that. Like I say, we've got painting, modelling, and more. The most important thing about bolt action and the hobby in general to me is actually playing the game. So we'll be doing you, showing you lots of us playing games. And also I'm going to do like how we started out, how we learnt the rules, where we start off with the basic thing you can get, which is 2 5-man units and a HQ. And I'll show you how we progress. Then after each game, because obviously they're only short, we had different variants in it. So the next game could have the same troop set up, but with a mortar added. Or then when we've got used to that, how the mortar works, a sniper team. When we've got used to that, we'll add a transport vehicle. And when we get used to that, and tanks and so on and so on, building up bigger and bigger games. We're still learning the rules. We have lots of house rules as well, which I think is important when you're playing games. Obviously not talking about tournaments or anything like that, but when you're at home playing in your kitchen like we do, we have a few house rules just to make the games flow a bit more smoother, or if we get stuck up on something, we don't have to go dig in and find out all the rules on it. Like when we first started with buildings, basically if you're in the area of the building, you're in it. It doesn't matter if you're on, like these are the only ones we started out with. Doesn't matter if you're on the high bit or the lower bit, all that just classes one building. And if you're in it, you've got the cover from it and the firing advantage. But as we're going along, obviously, when we come across something like that, we look more into the rule book, and we're finding out fantastic stuff as we go along. Because this gaming system, bolt action, is absolutely fantastic. It can be really strategic. Like you always look ahead. What's that enemy unit going to be doing? If he does that, what I'm thinking they're going to do? What can I do to counteract that? Or if he's got an anti-tank gun on ambush down at the bottom of the road, covering the road, so you've got problems crossing that road without getting shot by it, then bring your mortar team in, put some pressure on it, try and move him. And you can use your pieces of equipment or your models and units to counteract what you think the enemy could do in, or if they're doing something, what you can do to counteract their actions. And also, as you're playing along again, you can distract, which you have done in a couple of games we've played. I use these little tokens. They're just those glass beads you can buy, painted some red on them. We put them down, and they can be worth like 1 or 2 points. Apart from obviously when you destroy a unit, you get their dice, and that's a point as well. So I'd put pressure on one area, and you can see him moving there, worried about your tank that's going around there with a few troops behind it. And you get their idea off the objectives, which is another key role. If you have got objectives, keep that objective in mind. That's where the points are, and that's how you're going to win the game. But saying that, winning games, I don't mind if I lose, or if it's a draw, or if I win. It's just about playing the game and having fun with it. And you can have a lot of fun with ball action. And the best thing about it as well, I've always been a World War II freak, you could say, ever since I was little, massively into it. And my favourite units or tanks or vehicles and stuff like that and pieces of equipment are all covered by bolt action. And it's brilliant. Talking about modelling, my next project, I've just bought myself a King Tiger. Because who can have a German army? Well, that's, by the way, my army I play, without King Tiger. I bought this the other day, so I'm going to be unboxing it, show you around the model, building it, and then eventually playing it, so you can see my process of going through that. So I hope you bear with us. We're going to try and get a video out once every week or two, and as we go along, hopefully a few more. So keep coming back, see what we're up to, and hopefully we can help you if you're a new player. Show you how you don't have to get hung up so much about painting your models. I'll show you how I paint them. It's quick and easy. Some people might frown at me and think, oh, is that all you've done? But it's all about getting it on the table and getting playing with it. So come back to us and we'll try and help you out, and possibly you might pick something up. And don't forget, put comments down, we'll be reading them. If there's anything you'd like to see more of, or if you'd like to just concentrate on anything, or if you got, even if you got views against it, whatever, I'll read them all and I take everything with a pinch of salt. And I'm here to progress our journey through this game and through hobbying, and hopefully help you out as well. So thanks a lot, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, thanks.